everybody. Lance Russell and Dave Brown right along ringside. And by golly, we're ready to go with another big one this week on Championship Wrestling. David.
Oh, I tell you what, to start with, we got a tag team with plenty of size coming in here to get things underway. One of the interns is going to be teamed up with Playboy Frazier. Oh. We're talking about almost 700 pounds on one side of the ring. Johnny Wilhoit will be in here today, too, as wrestling is part of a tag team. Dirty White Boys will be going. Joe Lightfoot, who is in the territory for the first time a couple of weeks ago. He's out of Quebec. He will be here in a tag team match today. Also, we will be looking at Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, teamed with Iron Mike Sharp to go against the Batten Brothers, Mark and Brad. A little bit later on, the King, Handsome Jimmy Valiant, and their partner Buck Zumoff will be here. And they will be in six-man tag team action that should be something else.
Okay, that sounds like a dandy. We'll have a chance to meet a couple of new wrestlers, and by golly, just see a lot of good action. If we're going to get it, we better get on it. We'll be back in just one moment.
Nice on body work and a good paint job, too. Econo takes pride in doing good work to make your car look great. Econo's been around a while because they do good work, and you'll get a better price in winter when demand is down. So if your car needs a little body work and a good paint job, don't wait till the price goes up. Come on down to Econo now. Bad weather means good news for your car.
You think of appliances in 1985, think Fleming Fine Furniture, because we're going to blow your mind with big savings. Whether it's VCRs, cameras, TVs, stereos, washers, dryers, refrigerators, or freezers, we've got them at those famous Super Fleming prices. Like a famous Whirlpool Deluxe washer and dryer, both pieces only $6.99. A Whirlpool 18-foot frost-free refrigerator, $6.29. Fleming's January Price Buster sale kicks off big savings for 1985. Just say Target at the Fleming store near you.
Many of you already know when Lewis Ford has a sale, it's a real sale, not certain stock numbers or certain cars on the showroom floor. For the rest of this month, we're putting special low price tags in every car and truck in stock. And to prove that a Lewis Ford sale is a real sale, we want you to try one. Buy any car or truck, and if you decide you don't want it for any reason, bring it back. Lewis Ford wants you to love it or bring it back. Only at Lewis Ford. $52.99 summer at I-240.
Leroy ignores an order forbidding dancing, tempers flare, and a confrontation on the next Fame.
Johnson, you just danced yourself right out of this school.
Find yourself another dance teacher. I quit.
Don't miss the excitement.
Geronimo!
The Emmy Award-winning Fame. Fame, 6 Sunday evening on TV5.
Be quiet.
Okay, if you guys will hold it down just a little, I will make the announcement for those people that do not know. The interns are, again, the Southern Tag Team
Champions. That's right. Southern Tag Team Champions, the interns. Every day is a holiday. Every night's a celebration, baby. I guess you got a film you're going to show. You've always got an excuse. You'd try to sneak a sunrise past the rooster. You'd always try to do something. One of my interns...
No excuse. I just want everybody to take a look and see. We have a film of one of the matches.
Yeah, one of the matches. Yeah, one of the matches. Okay. We done beat them three times. We done beat them three times, but that's right. One of my interns in surgery, you go ahead and show the film, but also I want you to show where he jerked me up and hit me, hit a cripple, man. Man, he shouldn't do that. What's wrong?
Let's take a look at it right now and let the people make up their mind about the intern. And the intern going for a suplex. Big one, and he powered him down on that floor. Count of one, two, and from behind, Lynn Denton drops a foot in there and breaks it up. Well, if you like them rough, brother, you haven't got anything to request from this one. It's had it all. Look at Anthony trying to battle his way out of the corner. Tag on Lynn Denton. Comes back to help out. 10 minutes passed. The interns knock the referee down as they bounce off of each other. Anthony's down. Referee Jerry Calhoun. Lynn Denton trying to get away from him. And once again, the interns not quick enough. for two down. Troy Graham throws that footrest of the wheelchair in. Lynn Denton intercepts it. The referee not in a position to count. Denton going after Troy Graham. Here comes Jimmy Hart. Hart nails Anthony from behind. Rolls out of the ring. Anthony down flat. The intern with an arm over him may get the count right here. Three, that's it. 11 minutes, 34 seconds. The winners will be the intern in an absolute brawl of the first order. The interns over the Dirty White Boys in 11:34.
Yeah, that was one of the matches. They ultimately beat the Rock and Roll for the title.
We also beat the Rock and Roll. We beat a lot of teams, but we're still the Southern Heavyweight Champions, baby. We will remain undefeated. Did you see him jerk me up out of my chair and hit me? He had brass knucks on, but I own my own diamond store, Abbott Diamond Enterprises, baby, and I had me a legal pair of brass knucks made, and I guarantee you Monday night it's going to be some sad singing and some slow walking. You understand what I'm saying? We're going to drop these boys right here like yesterday's garbage. That's my motto, baby, stronger than dirt. Troy, Too Sweet Graham, and his interns. You know, one of my interns is in surgery, but that's all we need is one intern.
All right, let's go to the ring. We're ready for action.
This will be a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match, introducing at a total weight of 455 pounds. From Lexington, Kentucky, Johnny Wilhoit, and his partner from Memphis, Tennessee, David Haskins. One against him at a total weight of 670 pounds. From Philadelphia, Playboy Frazier and his partner, parts unknown, with manager Troy Graham at ringside, the intern. One fall match, 10-minute time limit, Jerry Calhoun, the referee.
The noisy Troy Graham at ringside. We're ready for the bell. Here we go.
Graham in the wheelchair, rolling round and round the ring area down here. His intern in there starting things against Johnny Wilhoit. The intern looked like he was searching for a tag. He used the ropes, just leaned outside instead. That got a break on the hold that Wilhoit was putting on him. Each of them trying to put the other's arm in the hammer position.
Boy, the intern is so big, Dave. It's hard for Johnny to hold that side headlock. He's just so broad around there. Woohoo!
Ooh. Nice move by Johnny Wilhoit.
No tights, Troy. No tights.
Wilhoit made good use of the intern's own weight. Once he was able to get him moving, and centrifugal force took over. And once he started moving, he just kept moving. Oh, once that right hand started moving there, it said, Wilhoit, it's an into the turnbuckles and drops him with a nice slam coming off of there.
I like Jimmy Hart.
I know. Yeah. Yeah. I thought Hart was loud. I think he's almost, not quite, but almost met his match in Troy Graham when it comes to making noise. Johnny Wilhoit out of Lexington, Kentucky. Fine young wrestler. But going against the huge intern. Now there's hair pulling. I think you could see it pretty well from that camera angle. The intern just reached up and yanked Wilhoit down to the mat. Graham has just tossed like a garbage bag into the ring. The referee kicks it out of there. This is big Playboy Frazier. He uses that big telephone pole broad arm of his. Fires Wilhoit in over the ropes and clotheslines him coming off of there with a forearm.
I think he's big. Not much finesse, Dave, but no. He doesn't need much finesse.
He's at 420 pounds, 7 feet tall, and Wilhoit, good move as he gets to the corner. Makes the tag on his partner, David Haskins. Wilhoit had been in there a long time, about 2.5 minutes.
Haskins fires the intern into the turnbuckle, but a little inexperience on Haskins' part. He went in too quickly. Intern using the hair rammed Haskins into the turnbuckle. Troy Graham again out of the corner down the side of the ring.
Ooh, big upper arm by the intern. Haskins hits the mat.
Knee lift. Intern with a choke. Referee saw it. He's counting him off there. Count of three. He got two. Frazier. A big open-handed slap across the chest. Knocked Haskins off his feet. We're coming up on 4 minutes in this match. 10 minutes, the overall time limit. So far, it's been impressive size of Playboy Frazier and his partner, the intern, against Johnny Wilhoit. Wilhoit has made some fine moves. There's a good drop kick to move the intern back. Wilhoit goes after Frazier. Frazier, the legal man in the ring. Haskins in there to keep the intern out of it, but look out. Haskins thrown down on the floor. Graham with a folding metal chair right on the top of the head. He smacks him.
Nice.
Meanwhile, a referee trying to get Johnny Wilhoit away from Frazier in the corner. Frazier holding on to him. Intern with a cover on Haskins. Two. He got a three count. Well, 4 minutes, 35 seconds. The win's going to go to the intern and Playboy Frazier.
Nice use of the chair by Troy Graham in there. Haskins had been thrown out of the ring, down on the floor. The intern picks him up. Look at Graham while the referee is over there. Oh, boy. And I mean, drilled him with that chair, threw him back in the ring, and then it was a matter of one, two, three. Yeah, you nice using the chair, Troy. He did a marvelous job. We're going to take time out. We're going to be back with more action. The first of our five big bouts on Championship Wrestling today.
Carter Pontiac has the cars and the price. During the 84 demo final closeout sale, save $2,000 on this Parisienne. Now only $10,584. This T1000 now only $5,612. Buy this 84 Fiero for only $8,515. Or lease it and your payments are only $187 a month. Those are the prices. These are the cars. All drastically discounted now during the 84 demo final closeout sale at Pat Carter Pontiac.
We care about you. Unpainted Furniture's big liquidation sale features discounts up to 50% on their entire stock. Beautiful solid wood chests, hundreds of solid wood chairs, rockers, bedroom sets, hutches, dining room sets, bar stools, roll-top desks, room dividers, bookcases, china cabinets. Hundreds of solid wood furniture values with savings up to 50%. Quantities are limited, so hurry to Unpainted Furniture Center's big liquidation sale at both locations.
Don't take it out on your battery. Tune up for fast starts at Expert Tune. Your engine is computer analyzed and expertly tuned by certified mechanics you can talk to. A 30-minute guaranteed tune-up at Expert Tune costs less than a new battery. Expert Tune. For starters.
Jennifer's death scene in a community play could be the real thing when the director put real bullets in the stage gun. Murder Takes a Bow on Heart to Heart, Monday at 3:30 on TV5.
Help us. Children's Fun Drive, Lavana.
Thrill of a lifetime now. One of them's bad enough. We got to end up with both of them. I'm referring, of course, to Jimmy Hart and Troy Graham, president of the First Family and manager of the Interns. Coming up Monday night, we've got a match with the Hard as a Wimp. That's what it says. Monday night, we got a match. The Interns, the Dirty White Boys, Southern Tag Belts are on the line, but we also have got a fact that if the Dirty White Boys can beat the Interns, we got 5 minutes with their old manager, Jimmy Hart.
If is a very big word, Big Nose. If you had a small nose, everybody wouldn't be making fun of you either. But I guarantee you, baby, hey, they're not gonna get the win. They couldn't do it in three times, they're not going to do it Monday night. You understand what I'm saying?
Well, they've been awful close in every chance that they've had.
Hey, close don't get it, baby. Tell them, Jimmy.
Let me tell you something, Russell. You know, I'm a very, very busy man.
Oh, yeah.
Monday night. Now, I'm going to have to be in a little match, a stipulation match. Dirty White Boys against the Interns, probably one of the greatest teams in the history of professional wrestling, baby. The Dirty White Boys want to make excuses, you know. I did everything for the Dirty White Boys. I found them working at Walgreens drugstore, baby, up in Cleveland, Ohio, about a year and a half ago, right? I groomed them. I got them in the gym. I tried to get them to work out. One of the guys looks like he's got TV anyhow, baby. But I tried to make them into superstars. But the old thing's right. You can't polish you know what, right or wrong, baby.
That's right, I tried my best.
Now, let me tell you something, Dream Machine. When I managed you and Pork Chop Cash, I was always there behind you, wasn't I?
That's right, baby.
They were the Southern Heavyweight Champions, not once, not twice, but four different times, baby, before they were tried to be stripped of the titles by Eddie Marlin. Now, this is Eddie Marlin's scheme to try to get rid of Jimmy Hart once and for all because he knows the Dirty White Boys hate me.
Yeah,
and you know what? He believes, too.
He can't do it.
And he believes there's still some dissension between Dream Machine and Jimmy Hart, but you know.
I love you, baby.
You know that I've been with you forever, baby. That's right. This man loves me, Russell. He loves me. But just to make sure, Dream Machine, because one thing we do have in common, baby, and it's something I always talk to you when I used to manage you, and that's money, baby. I think if you count this, you're going to find not one, not two, but 10 $100 bills, $1,000 right here to you and your men to make sure that the Dirty White Boys don't put one hand on my pretty head, baby.
Money talks, and you know what walks, baby. I guarantee you are safe. There's a baby in this mammy's arms.
That's right, baby. The Dream Machine, that's right, baby. And his word's as good as gold with Jimmy Hart, and that's all I've got to say right now.
Well,
I've always been with him, and I've always stood behind him.
Whoa! Well, there went his old buddy, Jimmy Hart, out as the Dirty White Boys come in.
Hush, just 1 minute, brother. Where's Jimmy Hart now, huh?
Come on, boy.
Jimmy Hart now, brother. He put his track shoes on and hauled it out of here, Jack. Where's your so-called friend now, huh? He left you to the wolves, Jack. That's the kind of friend you got. Don't put your hands on me, boy. Don't put your hands on him, I'm telling you, boy. He left you to the wolves, Jack. You know what happens, man? You know what happens when you get left to the wolves, boy? They treat you like the wolves are treating you.
See what I mean? I went to get help. You tried to turn him against me, but I went to get help, baby. I didn't desert him. I went to get help. And I promise you this, we'll get rid of you clowns once and for all. You'll go back to Walgreens working when I get through.
Always got an answer.
Well, you can be tag team champion, right?
You guys almost had him. There's no question about that.
Let me tell you something, Lance Russell. Jimmy Hart has turned his back on us one too many times. He cost the title two times in a row, brother. No man does that. He stands up here and tells everybody we turned on him. He calls us chicken. He calls us yellow. Everything he can say. Well, I'm going to tell you something, Jimmy Hart. There's one thing we want more than the Southern Tag Team titles, and that's 5 minutes in the ring with you, brother.
Alone, Daddy.
It's time for Jimmy Hart to pay some dues, Jack. I want you bad. I want to do something to your head. And it'll make you pay.
I don't think it'll take 5 minutes.
And then that's all I want.
Walk
out
of
the ring with these tag team titles. Would that look good right here?
Would that look good, Lance?
Yeah.
Your turn's coming, Hart. Get ready for it.
Well, your turn's Monday night. Let's go to the ring now. We're ready for more championship wrestling action.
This will be a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match coming up here. Dirty White Boys stepping up into the ring right now. And their opponents are right along ringside and will be there momentarily. as they're up on the apron. Let's do the official introduction. From Memphis, Tennessee, the total weight is 427 pounds. Both from Memphis, Tennessee, introducing Pat Hutchinson and his partner, Bill Rose, and going against him at a total weight of 435 pounds from San Francisco, California, Lynn Denton, Tony Anthony, the Dirty White Boys. This match, one fall, 10-minute time limit, referee Jerry Calhoun.
Okay, we're pairing down to just two combatants in the ring. It'll be Bill Rose starting out against Lynn Denton of the Dirty White Boys. Hutchinson on the outside, Tony Anthony on the outside. Referee Jerry Calhoun into the corner very quickly, trying to get Rose back, but look at Denton take care of him. These Dirty White Boys, a couple of rugged son of a guns, Dave. They love to get in there and scrap.
I've never seen them in a match when they didn't come in at least 110%. Haven't always agreed with some of the things I've seen them do.
That's true.
Years gone by, but they are battlers. This Bill Rose, big guy. He's tall, weighs in at about, at about 235. He's got some good sized weight on him.
Bet you. Tied up, center of the ring. Anthony in there now with Bill Rose. Back to the ropes, a whip. Went to kick him coming off the rope, but Anthony was down for a backdrop. He grabbed his foot. Now Rose is over trying to tag Pat Hutchinson. Hutchinson doesn't seem too anxious to jump in there, does
he? No, as a matter of fact, he pulled his hand away from the tag. He didn't want in there. Oh! Top rope breaks. The turnbuckle, the hook that holds it in the corner there snapped. It broke. And Bill Rose flips on his back out on the apron, down on the floor.
Boy, that always, I don't care who it is, whether I like him, dislike him, or have no feeling at all, that always scares you because you're set with that rope to spring you back. It's like missing a drop kick, only about 10 times as bad. You go up and a guy backs up on a drop kick. You are not set for that. And Bill Rose went right over that top rope. In the ring now, Pat Hutchinson with Lynn Denton. And Denton picks him up. Power slams him down on the mat. Rose battling back up to the ring apron. There's a tag on Tony Anthony. We've only got two ropes, as you can see. That top one just broke. In the ring, Pat Hutchinson and Tony Anthony. Ooh.
Well, Rose has picked up the hook that was holding the rope up there. He's got it in his hand.
Oh, boy.
Back in the corner. Hutchinson, meanwhile, getting quite a beating from the Dirty White Boys in there.
Anthony hanging, and Lynn Denton, after the tag, comes in to take over on Pat Hutchinson. Blast him. A solid right hand. Shoulder, and look at Pat Hutchinson battle his way back, driving that shoulder into Denton's midsection. Hutchinson really coming after Denton. He was going for a body slam, but Denton blocked him. Goes over and tags. Here comes Bill Rose in there. Ooh, double. Oh, yeah.
Dirty White Boys take it in 3:09. They had that double drop. I think you see that rope hanging there. I think we can show you what happened. The ropes are held to those ring posts by some big, strong hooks. Watch
Real
Bill
quick,
Rose go into the rope, and he hits, and that rope just snaps. Look at him snap backwards over onto the apron, a flip completely down onto the floor. Fortunate he didn't do major damage to his back when that happened, but that hook just snapped. It just sheared right over there.
Dirty White Boys did a little damage when they got a hold of Pat Hutchinson.
They sure did. Got
Pat
the win.
Firing back, but it was a double on him. And what was the time again?
3:09.
3:09. We got more action coming up. Three big bouts to go, a six-man tag. Time out, and we'll be back in just a moment.
The The keyboard place is slashing prices on more than 200 pianos and organs during its big inventory reduction sale. Save up to 50% on beautiful Hammond, Kawai, Kimball, and Yamaha pianos, organs, and portable keyboards, like this walnut spinet piano, just $9.95. Or this great beginner organ by Kimball, now only $697.50. And this Kimball grand piano can be yours for just $3,884. These low prices won't last, so hurry to the keyboard place. Two locations, 1424 Union and 4515 Poplar.
Be the leader of the pack in a Pontiac. A Pontiac from the Pontiac pack.
The pack is back with the car that only a year ago set the automotive world on its ear. It's the innovative mid-engine Fiero. Now, here comes the Pontiac back with a 1985 Fiero with a newly available high-output V6 and a hot new GT version. Be the leader of the pack in a Pontiac Fiero from Pat Carter, Foster, and Courtesy.
Have fun buying Jolly Royal's rainbow of furniture value. For the next few days, you can feel good all over finding your pot of gold with this contemporary Herculon velvet hideaway living room. Look, the sofa's a queen-size hideaway. The chair, love seat, and hideaway have soft, loose pillows. Flick of the wrist operation. Not the $1,000 you'd expect to pay, but Jolly Royal's rainbow price of just $599 at Royal Discount. Free delivery, free layaway, and we carry our own account.
Here it comes, Tiger fans, the basketball game you've been waiting for this Saturday at the Showdown at noon when the mighty Tigers of Memphis State take on the Louisville Cardinals. The Twin Towers of Keith Lee and William Bedford will look to lead the nationally ranked Tigers to victory over Denny Crum's upset-minded Cardinals in the pressure cooker of Freedom Hall. When these two teams get together, it's college basketball at its best. The Memphis State Tigers and the Louisville Cardinals this Saturday at noon on TV5.
Okay, they're working on the ring now, trying to get that rope back up. A little field expedient measure as Eddie Marlin is out seeing if we can get that top rope back on, and we'll get back to the ring here in just a moment. While we're taking time out and they're fixing it up, I want to remind you a couple of things. Stay tuned immediately following our championship wrestling here on TV5 because, friend, you have got one whale of a basketball game coming up. Memphis State will be going against Louisville. Up in Louisville, and we're going to be taking a look at that. Hope they have an excellent day. It's been a while since they beat Louisville up in the confines of Louisville. And let's see, what else we got? The King Show, Jerry Lawler Show, tomorrow will be on at 11:30 rather than the usual time of 11 o'clock. So be certain to set your watches for 11:30 when you want to pick up the King Show. He's got a good one tomorrow. We'll have other information for... Oh, by the way, I want to again remind you, what's that hotline number? 685-6969. That's the wrestling hotline, opportunity for you to call it 24 hours a day, and every chance we get, we update it. Sometimes we don't get the information that you want on right at the right time, but we do try to keep it updated. 685-6969 for the hotline. Okay, let's take a look at the action coming up down at the Coliseum Monday night. Back on our regular time, but brother, I'll tell you one nice thing about it. You're going to be able to get in there with the entire family so that it's not going to run you an arm and a leg either. The ticket prices are going to be $4, $5, and $6, but children 10 and under will be admitted to general admission for just $1. That's right. Children 10 and under will be admitted to general admission for just $1. Opportunity for you to bring the entire family down, and you're going to see a night of champions, man, because we have got some action coming up Monday night. Let's take a look at the entire card. David Haskins and Johnny Wilhoit will be going against each other in the opening bout. Then another single match. You'll be seeing Kevin Kelly for the first time coming up in just a few minutes on Championship Wrestling. He will be facing Lanny Poffo. Then it'll be Jerry Bryant going against another brand new one in the championship wrestling area. We'll be meeting Rock and Roll Buck Zumoff a little bit later in the program. Following that is going to be a 10-man tag match. It'll have Dangerous Danny Hager, Joe Lightfoot, Ken Wayne, and Danny Davis, the Nightmares, teamed with Playboy Frazier on one side of the ring to go against Mark and Brad Batten, the Batten Twins and the Daydreamers, and their fifth man is going to be Tojo Yamamoto. That will be a spirited 10-man tag, to say the least. And then we start the championship matches. We're going to have a Central States Championship match that'll have the Macho Man, Randy Savage, challenging the Central States champion, Buddy Landell. You remember Buddy from months back. You've seen him right here with Championship Wrestling. He's holder of the Central States Championship, and he is on the road defending against Randy the Macho Man Savage. Following that will be an international title match that'll have Terry Taylor, who won that title right here in Memphis, still has a very, very fond spot in his heart for the Memphis folk. He'll be back defending against the one from the Royal Forest of Dean, the exotic Adrian Street, as he will be challenging Terry for the international title. Mid-America title. Boy, won't this be a scrap. Big Iron Mike Sharp will be defending against handsome Jimmy Valiant. We'll be talking to Jimmy a little bit later about that upcoming match. A Southern Tag Team title match where the interns with Troy Graham going against the Dirty White Boys. And if the Dirty White Boys can do it and beat the interns, they're going to get 5 minutes with Jimmy Hart. So they have a major double incentive for that Southern Tag title match. Then the final bout is going to be a Southern Heavyweight title match. The fifth of our five championship matches. Texas death rules will prevail, and I think most of you know that that means that there will be no falls counted. There will be falls, but none of them will count. It goes until one man cannot continue, and Eddie Gilbert will be challenging the Southern Heavyweight title holder, the King, Jerry Lawler. That's all Monday night, my friend. What we're talking about is prices that are going to let you in with the entire family, 4, 5, and 6, children 10 and under, just a buck. Parking, of course, still a buck. We'll be looking for you Monday night down there. Get your tickets all day today at the Coliseum or any of your Ticketmaster locations, and all day on Monday, as a matter of fact, they'll be open with the tickets. We'll take time out. We'll be back in just one moment.
My dandruff shampoo is good.
Maybe you should try something else. My dandruff shampoo really works.
Maybe you should try something else. Like Celsin Blue. Doctors and pharmacists recommend Celsin Blue more than all other leading brands combined. It's number one. What that means to you is no leading brand gets rid of dandruff better than Celsin Blue. Ask your doctor or pharmacist, or try it yourself. That's all the proof you'll need. Celsin Blue. It's number one.
Well, I'll tell you, a guy coming in here is one of the most popular wrestlers ever to be around the Memphis area. He is the current holder of the international title. He took that title away from Eddie Hot Stuff Gilbert. Gilbert, who thinks the whole world is his championship. He'll be challenging Lawler for the Southern heavyweight, but he still remembers Taylor. I want you to remember Terry Taylor, too. Let's take a look at him right now.
Thank you.
Hey, that's Terry Taylor, and I'll tell you, he is some kind of specimen of an excellent young athlete, and I think he stunned Eddie Gilbert when he took that international title for him. He has been most successful in defending it. And coming up with us right now will be his challenger for Monday night from England, the exotic Adrian Street with Miss Linda. You have got a very tough champion coming up, Adrian.
Yes, Lance, I'm really looking forward to it. As you know, I've been European champion on four different occasions. I've been champion of 37 different countries, in actual fact. Apart from the fact that I'm really looking forward to taking Terry Taylor's belt away from him, which I'm sure I'll do sort of quite easily, I just can't wait to get my hands on Terry Taylor. I mean, he's so cute. He's got such pretty little teeth, you know. And I've rearranged, I mean, as you know, since I've been in the United States of America, I've rearranged so many people's dental work that on the East Coast, they call me the Demon Dentist, and on the West Coast, they call me the Tooth Fairy. I mean, he's got a very pretty little face at the moment, you know, a very pretty picture. By the time I'm finished with him, he's going to look like a jigsaw puzzle with half the pieces missing. And all his music that he got, nobody's original. Everybody sort of steals everybody else's rock and roll music and everything like that. Come in the ring and they sort of flop about all over the place. I do my own thing. The many talented Adrian Street, I mean, apart from wrestling, I wouldn't trust any of these silly rock and rollers to sing anything that I'd come in. I do my own song. Everything is my own, original.
Well, I am well aware of that particular fact. I'm going to be interested to see just how...
In actual fact, when are you going to show my special?
Adrian,
it's been specially made for MTV.
Right.
You know, and these lucky people, these hillbillies here, are going to have like a little preview.
Adrian, if you'll wait, we'll take a break. And when we come back, we will, in fact, let everybody have a look at the original Adrian Street. Let's take time out. We'll be back in just a minute.
Hey, smell that fresh buttered popcorn.
Gee, Eddie, nothing can penetrate this stuffy nose.
This can.
Hall's mentholiptus?
Yeah, with vapor action. Hall's vapor action penetrates deep into clogged nasal passages to help your stuffy nose feel clearer, while Hall soothes your throat to help your cough.
Wow, that's great.
The popcorn?
No, the Hall's.
For penetrating relief, get Hall's vapor action and try sugar-free Hall's, too.
You know, I've always been impressed by strength, and that's why I'm impressed by the product of my friends at Mid-South Builders. Now, they offer all kinds of siding for your home, but they specialize in U.S. steel siding. When you let Mid-South Builders put super steel siding on your home, you're going to save on depreciation, save on fuel bills, and end costly house painting forever, not to mention that it's rust-proof, termite-proof, and fire-resistant. Mid-South Builders has offered quality workmanship for over 25 years, and they offer complete remodeling services. They got financing available with easy terms and free estimates. Call them today at 948-0461.
Showtime!
Oh, no, not again.
Daddy, in the new TV. Now!
Hello, Remco!
Call Remco. You can rent to own a cable-ready GE Zenith or RCA console color TV.
At Remco, we can rent to own a brand new cable-ready color TV?
Yes, and that's a promise. Remco's affordable rental purchase plan makes it so easy, you won't even need credit.
Hello, Remco.
Hello. We'll deliver today.
When I race through a meal, I get terrible indigestion.
How do you spell relief?
R-O-L-A-I-D-S. 100% relief.
For millions of Americans, Rolaid spells 100% relief.
We are standing here with the exotic Adrian Street and Miss Linda, and we do, in fact, have your music presentation ready, Adrian.
Oh, I'm enchanted. I just can't wait to see it again. It's made specially for MTV, you know, and these lucky people are going to have a chance to have, like, a little preview, you understand? Shut up yourself. Ignorant people.
Okay, well, let's do it right now. Let's take the opportunity to see an original by Adrian Street.
Wonderful.
I'm in love. I'm so in love. I'm in love. I'm so in love.
I don't need research. For someone to adore, I've already given up my heart. And the love I have is all accounted for. I've fallen for a gorgeous work of art. When I want to see the fairest of them all,
than just admire the view.
I'm in love with me. So in love with me. I have a job to drag myself away. I find it very difficult to get me off my mind, but that's the price perfection has to pay. I'm in love with me. So in love with me.
Okay, we're at the ring right now. Dave, ready for the official introductions on this next bout.
It'll be a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match. Introducing from Memphis, Tennessee, at 221 pounds, Ken Raper over on the right of the screen. And going against him from Oakland, California, 271 pounds, the blonde bomber, Kevin Kelly. This match will be one-fall, 10-minute time limit. Jerry Calhoun's the referee.
Whoogie doke, we got a couple of large ones in there right now. We always remark the fact that Raper has excellent size. He's in there with a guy that's even bigger than he is, Dave.
Yes, he is. Weight and height. Boy, this Kelly's a big guy. Oakland, California, in the Bay Area out there, where apparently they taught him to choke real well back in the tournament.
Yeah, maybe you need to choke out there if you're in Oakland. We have the Dirty White Boys out of San Francisco.
Oh,
now
right.
Kevin Kelly in from Oakland.
Kelly hammering broad arm across the back of Ken Raper. Raper up in the air. Kelly didn't. You slammed him, but it wasn't your conventional body slam. He kind of tossed him about 3 feet.
Him off of there, huh?
Raper, backdrop high in the air. Boy, he hit hard when he came down on that mat. Kelly with a count of one. Count of two, that's all he could get. He was pretty confident that he had Raper pinned. He was going to count off with the referee. One, two, but a two count, Raper kicked out of it. And he's still in the action. There he is right there, Ken Raper. There is big Kevin Kelly, the blonde bomber. Up in the air, he's suplexed by Kelly.
Powering. Looking way up in the air. Ken kicks out again. Kelly not able to pull off what he has in his mind that he has already pulled off, and that's get a pin on Ken Raper. Caught him with a heavy knee right in the midsection that time. Ken Raper has just not been able to get started. He has one little burst in there, but Kelly has essentially dominated this action.
Kelly with a broad arm across the back again. Kelly has dominated. He just hasn't been able to get Raper to the point. He's been able to hit him. There's a knee left. Boy, that can knock him down to the mat.
He's had two pin attempts on him. Both of them have gone as far as the two count, and Ken has been able to come out of it and avoid the pin. Standing side headlock, Kelly is getting his back to the ref, where I can assure he was applying some of that choke again, Dave.
Flips Raper back into the ring after using the top rope.
Kevin Kelly, Ken Raper in the ring. Raper in the yellow or light tights, and Kevin Kelly in the black tights.
Raper's in one of those situations in this match, though, where he doesn't have time to really go after Kelly. He's too busy defending himself. Kelly dropped down. There's a cover. One, two, and that would get it. Count of three. He was finally able to wear Raper down enough that he was able to hold him for the three count. Kevin Kelly, pretty well in control of his match. Our first look at him here on Championship Wrestling. 3:20 was the time.
When you turn him around as many times as Ken Raper was turning, he didn't realize where he was. If he'd have realized exactly where he was, I think he could have caught a rope with his foot in there. But in any event, as Kelly, with Raper on the shoulder, drives him into that knee. Boy, oh, boy. And Ken is down. And, of course, the count followed that. 1, 2, 3. The winner, Kevin Kelly over Ken Raper. We have got a big tag match coming up. Gilbert and Sharp against the Batten Twins in just a moment.
Dear sir, you'll love this search encounter. I knew camping wasn't for me, but the hike proved it. Oh well, I thought, I'll just brush off the dust and have a search. It had to be fate, because out of nowhere came a huge backpack attached to the best-looking guy.
Only Certs has a lively, fresh flavor and a glistening drop of Redson, so it's all you need to freshen your breath and keep it that way.
Well, Certs, looks like we're going camping more often.
Certs and sugar-free Certs, just in case you're going to be face-to-face.
If you're renting or thinking about renting a TV or appliance, listen up, because I'm talking about saving you money. At Central Appliance, we carry name brand TVs, stereos, washers, dryers, refrigerators, all your appliance needs at rates lower than any of our competitors. Why pay more? Call us. We guarantee it.
Central, we make living easy.
We got the drive. We're on the beam. We're the winners. We got the team. Listen to this. Your GMC truck team dealers will sell you this full-size pickup truck equipped with special option package at a good price. And air conditioning comes along with it at no extra charge. One reason why more people are buying GMC trucks than any time in history. A good truck, a good value, and air conditioning at no extra charge at your Mid-South GMC truck team dealers.
It was a sacred Paiute burial ground, but he didn't know it. He had stolen one of their women to nurse his infant son.
You mean like graveyard?
Now showing.
Okay, we're going to be in the ring here in just a moment. We got a super tag match coming up. You're going to see Big Iron Mike Sharp and Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert teaming together to go against the team of the Batten Twins, Mark and Brad. Ought to be a real scrap. Size on one side, and here's Big Iron Mike Sharp. Holder of the Mid-America heavyweight title match.
That's right, that's right. Mid-America. That's right. You know, I understand this handsome Jimmy Valiant has been stupid enough to put his John Henry on the line to get in the ring with Iron Mike. It seems like he hasn't had enough of this. You know, I clobbered him pretty good in Memphis recently. So badly the guy had to give up. His corner gave up. They're waving that flag. Didn't they, Jimmy? You saw it. Everybody there saw it. They waved the flag. They couldn't take it. You know, this big white arm right here. Just couldn't take it. Look at that arm, 20 inches of power. You know, I was hammering him right and left all over the ring. He didn't know if he was coming or going. He didn't know if he was up or down, he was inside or outside. And I'll guarantee you, he wants to get in there, and he wants this stretcher. What do they call this, a stretcher match? Is this what they call this?
You got a title on the line. I know.
Oh, okay, it's not a stretcher match. This is a title match right here, Mid-American. But I'll tell you something, he's going to be carried out in a stretcher when I get my hands on him. Because there's just no way. I've had enough of this guy. He's humiliated me enough, and there's going to be no more. I guarantee you that.
Well, you beat him with that arm brace
meet
enough.
The new. I promise you, he'll be the new Southern heavyweight champion, baby. King Edward right here.
You got your chance. And, brother, this one is a Texas death match rules, Eddie, where falls down.
Wait. I'll stop you right there. I have the rules right here. If we get a good camera shot here, I like to explain to all these rednecks out here and these goofy people exactly what a Texas death match means. And it means falls don't count. That doesn't matter how many times that I pin Jerry Lawler's shoulders to the match continues. Then there's no time limit. It can go all night long, right, Lance? You saw one of those matches that went 40-something falls, right? Okay, there's no disqualification. That means the referee can't stop it. No matter what I bring into the ring, no matter whatever Lawler brings to the ring, he can't stop the match. And then no stopping the match for blood. That's my kind of stipulation. Because when I get Lawler down and I beat him like the dog that he is, and make him bleed, brother, they can't stop the match. And then it goes. This is the final thing. It goes until one man can't answer the bell. And Lawler, I want to tell you something, brother. You've been around a long time. But Eddie Gilbert's going to be around a lot longer, brother. You're not hungry anymore. I am. I am the new king of wrestling. And after Monday night, I will be the new Southern heavyweight champion. And I'm going to be looking for some new contenders.
Well, we'll find out how that Texas death, whether it favors Hot Stuff or the king.
It's going to be a big night, baby. The Mid-America belt, the Southern heavyweight
belt. Five champions.
You better believe it, baby. The biggest night in the history of professional wrestling right there in Memphis, Tennessee. And I promise you this, brother. I promise you this, Lawler. Once we win the belt, and we will, you're never going to get a return shot. And that's a promise, baby. You'll have to retire from professional wrestling, baby. Oh, 85, man. Baby. 85.
We'll see Sharp Lawler against Valiant. We'll see Hot Stuff going against the king. Right now, let's go to the ring.
Okay, Mike, you got it. Iron Mike Sharp depositing the championship belt he has on the way to the ring in a non-title match here. Tag team match coming up. One fall, 10-minute time limit match. Total 491 pounds over on the left side of the ring. Introducing from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, Iron Mike Sharp. His partner from Lexington, Tennessee, Hot Stuff, Eddie Gilbert. They have Jimmy Hart in their corner. And going against him at a total weight of 454 pounds from Charleston, West Virginia, the Batten twins, Mark and Brad. This match will be one fall, 10-minute time limit, and the referee is Jerry Calhoun. All right, Eddie Gilbert, Hot Stuff, starting against one of the Battens. I got to tell you, I find it very difficult
like
to tell
company,
Mark
neighbor?
And Brad apart.
Well, you got company, baby. Guess who's coming to dinner?
Jimmy Hart joining us at the desk for a Sterling Brand of commentary, I'm sure. Eddie Gilbert, a little shocked at the goings-on. Jimmy Hart leaves his commentary position here, thank goodness. He goes back for a little word of conversation with Iron Mike Sharp and Eddie Gilbert. Meanwhile, the Batten brothers waiting patiently. Gilbert backs him into the ropes. Referee wants a break. Clean one. He gets it. Gilbert doesn't let him have it with the right hand. Batten moved out of the way. Gilbert tried to hold up.
That's okay. He's tough, baby.
Ring.
He's tough. Gilbert's tough, baby.
Made a big mistake early in the match. High five by the Batten brothers.
High five by the Batten brothers.
They
big deal.
Used their head. Outsmarted Hot Stuff, Eddie Gilbert. Made him look bad. Look out. Mike Sharp with that big
beautiful,
forearm.
Mike, beautiful. Never turn your back on the family. You know what our motto is? Like I told you last week, baby. The cheap shot, baby, is the best shot.
Yeah. The admission from Jimmy Hart, that's 2 weeks in a row we've heard the phrase. We've known that for a long time, but he's finally admitted it. First family members using the cheap shot at every opportunity. Mike Sharp.
Beautiful, Mike. Beautiful, baby.
Ramming Batten's head into the turnbuckle. First on one side of the ring and then the other. I got Gilbert's foot. Ooh, and Batten's head bounces about 2 feet back after he ran into the foot. I'm Eddie Gilbert.
You know, the Battens, they look cute, all right. Look, the little beards are trimmed nice and neat. They've got the little college hairstyles that all the college boys wear. Look at the little black knee pads matching, the little white boots, right? But the only thing wrong with it, they don't know how to wrestle, man. Look at Mike Sharp and look at Eddie Gilbert. Now, they know how to wrestle. They know what to do in the ring. They know when they get in trouble exactly what to do, baby. Ooh. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful?
Gilbert flying through the air, nails back.
Pull him up, pull him up. Beautiful, Eddie. Pull him up, baby.
He did pick him up by the hair at the count of one.
Look at that. Beautiful.
Fist. Double fist, both of them.
Like I said, baby, 85 is going to be the first family's year. You know, I thought 84 was going to do it, but I had a couple of slow leaks in there like the Dirty White Boys, man. They set me back about 6 months.
Backdrop by Eddie Gilbert. Hot Stuff has taken control of the match. He makes the tag now, and Iron Mike Sharp, his partner in the corner.
You know, why didn't his brother come in and help him? You saw it right there. You know why he didn't? Because, see, there's a weak link on every team, baby, except the first family team. I don't put any weak links in the first family. If they are weak, we get rid of them.
The weak link in this case you're talking about is abiding by the rules. The Batten's waiting for the tag, and the first family
paying very little attention to the rules.
That's right, slap him, Eddie. That's right, baby,
from
slap
him. Outside, Eddie Gilbert popped him with an open hand.
Show him who the king is, baby. Show him who the boss in the ring is, baby.
Oh, that big forearm. That arm brace that Mike Sharp wears that so many wrestlers have complained about.
You know what? And they complain about it. Everybody knows what happened to Mike Sharp's arm. He was hurt playing cocky, man.
Everybody knows what Mike Sharp says happened to his arm.
I can't even talk today. I feel like an elephant sitting on my tongue. He was hurt playing hockey out here. I was just warming your chair up for you, Russell.
Thank you for keeping it warm, Jim.
Sharp being backed away by the referee. And look at Eddie Gilbert from outside on the apron. We've been batting tied up in there. Look out, Eddie Gilbert with a suplex. There's a cover, count as one, two, and Gilbert picks him up by the hair at the count of two. Again, Gilbert and Sharp, that team, refusing to go for the count of three. Whether they could have gotten it or not, we don't know, but fact is, he didn't even go for it. Batten thrown through the rope, down onto the floor. Look out, Mike Sharp. Ooh, throwing him into and over the desk. And lying on the floor over here.
That's so stupid.
Watch him over here. Yeah, watch him. Get him away from it. Brother will help him.
No, he's laying out there because his brother didn't help him. His brother's not going to help him.
Oh, yeah, Mike Sharp grabbing him again down here on the floor.
Everybody wants to wrestle like. Look at you and Dave Brown even wrestling like. These kids wrestling like, but it's still to make you good announcers, still to make you good wrestlers, baby.
Thank you, Jimmy.
Eddie Gilbert. Trying to take advantage of the opportunity after Batten was thrown over our desk down here. Look out, drop kick by Eddie Gilbert. He caught him in the midsection. The Battens have been in trouble a good part of this match. Eddie Gilbert climbing the ropes now. Hot stuff. Going for the smash. And Batten was not there. That's the second time in the match that Eddie has missed. Here's Mike Sharp in after
got
the tag.
Him yet.
Oh, I haven't got him yet. You know, I'm a very, very busy man, baby. I've been flying all over the world the last 3 or 4 weeks, the last couple of months. But now I'm back in town to take care of business, baby.
Two count by Sharp, and he picked him up. As again.
Workout. We could have beat these punks maybe 5 minutes ago, but we just want to have a little workout before our big match.
Oh, boy. Yeah,
the arrogance of
you hit the word right on the head. Oh.
Well, he got Batten hung up on the top rope there. Gilbert holding up there. Hart
looking at
his hair. Batten really needs to get back over to the corner to tag his brother. They have kept him in there forever.
Really gets under your skin, man. I will tell you what.
We have just passed the 7-minute mark. Overall time limit, 15 minutes on this one.
Oh. Sharp with that pounding arm with that brace on it.
Gilbert. Then with a forearm. Eddie Gilbert with a cover. Count is one, two. But again, he picks him up with a two count.
We'll beat him when we're ready to beat this little punk.
Using hair and you in the corner and everything.
I tried to help him back in the ring, man. You
Jimmy,
saw that,
will you quit that?
Come on, get him out now.
I think everybody's an idiot but you.
You said it, I didn't.
Gilbert with a power slam. Iron Mike Sharp, unhappy with the crowd, trying to get something going to inspire the Battens.
Well, Gilbert and Sharp, they just had it going. Look at here now.
Reversal. Sharp's head banged into the turnbuckle. And the Batten twins going after him. One's got Mike Sharp, the other Eddie Gilbert, and they run them together in the center of the ring.
Oh, boy.
Look out. From outside, Frazier with a chair. Gilbert with a cover. One, two, and three. This one's over. Outside interference. Frazier comes in here.
Used everything but wrestling tactics in there. You grab the chair.
I don't got nothing. You don't even understand what you're talking about. You never know. Not you.
Yeah, well, I want to tell you one thing. You guys didn't end up there beating them all that easy.
I
want to
tell you one thing, too. You listen, and you boys, you listen. They've been running around here telling everybody how bad they beat me. They ain't beat me. Two midgets can't beat me. 10 midgets can't beat me. Ain't nobody gonna beat me.
$500 of yours.
They ain't nobody got
$500. See, that's the story he's making up. That's right. Nobody's ever taken that.
You crazy.
He's tired of spreading lies on Playboy Frazier. These two midgets can't beat anybody. This is one of the greatest wrestlers in the world.
And they shut up calling me a big fan. I ain't no big fan.
You know what? I'm sick and tired of my men being abused by these people. Look at this. Come on, Playboy.
There's a few other people that are sick and tired of stuff just like taking Batten and firing him all the way over the top of this desk in here. Absolutely ridiculous when he used that kind of tactic. We had Hart jerking his hair out here. Frazier picks the chair up in there. The Battens didn't have it. There it is. Look at here. Frazier holding the chair. Now, don't tell me that he wasn't interfering from the outside. Unfortunately, the referee was tied up trying to get the other pair separated in there, and Batten's head run right smack dab into the chair, and that counted for the 1-2-3. We've got more action. We've got us a big six-man match coming up with the King and Handsome Jimmy, and we'll be meeting rock and roll Buck Zumoff in just a few minutes.
South Coliseum in Memphis at 8 o'clock tonight. Presented by Gogo the Gorilla and Miss TNT. See full classes of ground-pounding 4x4s, wheelie-popping two-wheel drive trucks, and engine-blowing dragster tractors. Plus incredible super pullers. Mad Dog, the car-crunching monster 4x4, and Mac Attack, the wheel-standing semi. Coming to Mid-South Coliseum in Memphis at 8 o'clock tonight.
In a world of millions, the nicest things still happen between just two people.
Oh, Tip!
And when you brush your breath with Dentine, being together is nicer for everyone.
You're really here.
Because not even mouthwash can freshen your breath better than when you're chewing lively, long-lasting Dentine.
When the whole wide world with you, now it's down to just you two. Brush your breath with Dentine.
Travel Right RV is having a free spring sale. Our new spring merchandise has already arrived, and we're busting at the seams with the best selection of quality-built new Jayco motorhomes, fifth wheels, travel trailers, and tent campers starting at only $13.95. Everything on Travel Right's huge lot is on sale. You'll find something for everyone and a price to fit any budget during the free spring sale at Travel Right RV, 4050 North Thomas.
Give a friendly bye. Give a friendly bye. Just wave hello and watch it all go with a friendly bye. Turn on that smile and put on that dial. That heads for the heart when you start with a friendly bye.
Tell you the absolute truth. Sometimes when you see Hart and that first family and the stuff that they pull off in there, brother, you just can't help but get irritated about it, and you feel like you'd like to take a chair and go after them. Don't do it, man. That's a good surefire way to get in trouble in there. But they ended up with a victory over the Batten twins as they use not only Gilbert and Sharp and Hart, but Playboy Frazier. Well, with blow up our scheme, I was just saying that you can't help but get hot at guys like Gilbert and that smart aleck, and Davey hit it right on the head, that arrogant attitude that they got.
Well, whenever you feel like that, Lance, don't take the law into your own hands.
You got that right.
Take them. No, don't even take them to court. Call the wimp buster, brother. That's all you got to do.
I love
ready
it.
Ready for him.
By golly, I'll tell you one thing. We have got one fired up set of matches coming in here. Monday night at the Coliseum, we got five championship matches. One of them will involve a Texas death match rules, and Eddie Gilbert very meticulously went over every one of the rules, and he says he's going to walk away with that Southern
title. Well, it's nothing Eddie Gilbert would like more than to walk away with a Southern title. You got that right. He thinks that the King's days are over, brother. He thinks that he is waiting in the wing, that he is going to be the new heir to the throne, and when he knocks me off and takes this title, that he's going to reign supreme in Memphis. Well, I got news for you, Eddie Gilbert. If they took that little pea brain of yours and put it in a thimble, it'd roll around like a BB in a boxcar, brother, if that's what you think, because I got news for you, son. You have never seen the day. You have never seen the day, and you will never see the day that you can come out on top of the King in a Texas death match. I can promise you that, because as you said, with the stipulations, let me go over them one more time, Eddie Gilbert. I saw you out here with your little sign and running over the rules, and they were right, brother. The falls don't count. It may go one or it may go 50. It may go all night long. So you better pack a lunch, punk, because you're going to be there a while. I can guarantee you that.
Jerry, before you go over any more, let me interrupt you and say that Gilbert figures that that fact that falls don't count and it can go a long time, you're going to wear down a whole lot quicker than he does. He doesn't seem to know that you're one of the original slow starters, long finishers.
I hope, Gilbert, I hope that's what you're thinking, punk. I hope so, brother, because I just want you to come down there and think that you're going to wear me down. I could take everything you got. You come, brother. You come loaded to the hilt. You shoot your best shot. Do everything that you can, brother, everything in your whole arsenal, and you're going to see that the King will take it, and I'll still be standing there looking you eye to eye, and I'll have some little surprises for you, brother, because there's no time limit, and there's no disqualification. Now, Lance, you know what no disqualification means, don't you? That means if the King were to revert back to his old ways, like pulling out a chain, or if he were to throw the fire or something like that, the referee can't stop the match. He can't do a thing about it.
Could that happen?
Well, Lance, could that happen, brother? Let me ask you. Let me tell you something about this, Eddie Gilbert. They can't stop the match because of blood if you're bleeding from head to toe, punk. If you're begging the referee to stop it, if you're pleading with him, he can't do it. It only stops when one man can't answer the bell.
Right.
And I can assure you that I'm not ready to step down from the throne. This is my belt, this is my crown, and this is my town, punk, and it's going to be for a long, long time.
Good luck to you, Jerry. I'll tell you, I can't wait for the... Oh, here he is. Good night. Oh,
let's see. I want to see all my people, all my brothers and sisters in Memphis. You know, Elvis Presley would have been 50 years old this last birthday. When was his birthday, you know?
It was January the 8th, I believe.
Are you sure?
No.
Well, it may be next week or it could have been last week.
That's right.
But all I know, Handsome Jimmy started these sideburns on his birthday because Elvira and Elvis Presley are two of my favorite people, and they both have sideburns. So Handsome Jimmy's going to be supporting some sideburns now.
Right.
Now, I'm going to tell you something about this shop-dressed man I'm talking about, I'm Mike Shop. You know, the man never takes a shower. He never brushes his teeth. He never takes a bath. He's dirty, you understand? I'll call Mr. Dutt. Well, I'm talking to Shop Dress Man on Mark Shop. You know, he comes out with this band on his arm. He says it's from a hockey injury, bruh. He says this is from some type of old athletic injury, you see.
Gotta have it.
Well, I got a surprise for you. Monday night in my hometown, Memphis. Listen to me, brothers and sisters. This is what's gonna happen. You see, he is an ex-hockey player. And when the Boogeyman Handsome Jimmy comes out, he's gonna come out like this. Hey!
Whoa! Look at that.
I'm gonna knock the hockey right out. Right out of my shot. Woo! Feel good, feel good.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's just two of the matches. Mid-America title match, Southern Heavyweight title match. You gotta be there Monday night. Okay, Dave, we got action around the territory.
Woo!
Oh, we do indeed. Hey, a couple of quick reminders for you. Programming here on TV5. You are about 18 minutes away from what may be the Metro basketball game of the year. Memphis State Tigers against Louisville here on TV5 coming up right after us at 12 noon. Tomorrow, the Jerry Lawler Show on at a special time, 11:30. Dirty White Boys, Troy Graham, Adrian Street, and a couple of local professional boxers. 11:30 tomorrow only for the Jerry Lawler Show. Okay, championship wrestling around the territory, Camden, Tennessee tonight. I beg your pardon, on Friday night, January 25th. Friday night, Camden, Tennessee, championship wrestling action. You'll see the folks that'll be there. Same night, Forest City, Arkansas. The Lawler will be there. The Daydreamers, Johnny Wilhoit, Eddie Gilbert, and more. Forest City, Arkansas, Friday the 25th. Saturday the 26th in Jonesboro, Arkansas. Tickets are now available for championship wrestling, which will be at the American Legion Arena there. Monday, January 28th in Grenada, Mississippi. This will be at 7:30 that night at the high school. Tickets are available at the high school. Louisville, Arkansas, Friday, February 1st. Now, you folks that have tickets from the last snow out in Blytheville, Arkansas, when all the snow came in and couldn't have wrestling up there. If you have tickets that were for that date, they will be good on Friday, February 1st in Blytheville, Arkansas. Sunday, the 3rd, Jackson, Tennessee. It'll be at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Going to be a big card up in Jackson on the 3rd. On Friday the 8th in Kennett, Missouri. Friday the 8th in Dixon, Tennessee. Thursday, February 14th, championship wrestling in Fulton, Mississippi at Itawamba Junior College. On Friday the 15th in Somerville, Tennessee. And on Friday, February 22nd, championship wrestling will be in Corinth, Mississippi. And we'll be back with more championship wrestling in a moment.
My dandruff shampoo is good.
Maybe you should try something else. My dandruff shampoo really works.
Maybe you should try something else, like Celsin Blue. Doctors and pharmacists recommend Celsin Blue more than all other leading brands combined. It's number one.
What that means to you is no leading brand gets rid of dandruff better than Celsin Blue. Ask your doctor or pharmacist, or try it yourself.
That's all the proof you'll need. Celsin Blue. It's number one.
Something, Russell.
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you something, man. Look what Hester Jimmy's trying to put on you, Mike Sharp, wearing the arm brace.
Listen, I don't care for this at all. He's got no business wearing that thing on his arm. I have a legitimate reason for wearing this. My arm is injured. It was broken in 17 places playing hockey. Why is he wearing that? He has no right. Like the man. Like the man to wear. Why is he wearing that? I'm going to go to the wrestling commissioner about that. He's got no business wearing something like that.
You better have something in store, because, brother, I'll tell you what, Jimmy is ready for it. Let's take a look at the action coming up Monday night, all of it. A big night of champion action, and I want to tell you, the ticket prices are right, 4, 5, and 6, with children 10 and under admitted to general admission, just $1. Bring the whole family. Get there at 8 o'clock to see the first of the bouts, David Haskin against Johnny Wilhoit. Then it'll be Kevin Kelly. You'll see him in action against Lanny Poffo. Jerry Bryant will be going against rock and roll Buck Zumoff. A big 10-man tag match with the Battens of the Daydreamers and Yamamoto against Danny Hager, Lightfoot, the Nightmares, and Playboy Frazier. Then we start with the 5 championship matches, the Central States Championship heavyweight battle with the Randy Macho Man Savage going against Buddy Landell. Following that, an international title match. The exotic Adrian Street will be challenging Terry Taylor for the international title. Mid-America title, Jimmy Valiant, who had a sudden turn for the worst in that right arm and had to put a brace on it, will be going against Iron Mike Sharp. Southern tag team title with the interns against the Dirty White Boys. And if the White Boys can win it, they'll get 5 minutes with Hart. The final one, Southern heavyweight match. Texas death rules apply. Eddie Gilbert, Jerry Lawler. That's going to be something else of a night. Be down there Monday night, 8 o'clock. We'll take time out. Be back in just a moment.
In the Broadway musical Zorba.
This is how the time goes by.
Zorba is coming to the Orpheum to get your tickets. Call 525-3000. Anthony Quinn is Zorba. Get your tickets to the Broadway legends.
If you don't know about Champion TV and how you can get a color TV, stereo, or major appliance for just 99 cents, you're missing out. All you got to do is call this number right now, 1-800-233-RENT. With just 99 cents, you can rent to own with no credit hassles, no security deposit, no long-term obligations. If you call 1-800-233-RENT right now, you could be enjoying your new TV, stereo, or major appliance tomorrow. Call Champion now.
Champion makes it easy to own.
Men, woman, hot pan woman.
Put your hands together on the hot Big Mac.
Hot, 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 hot.
Don't it warm your hands, make you want to clap.
Filet and fish, a hot, hot dish.
It's a good time for the great taste.
Big Mac, quarter pounder, french fries, chicken, 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 McNuggets. Pan woman,
it's a good time for the great taste. McDonald's.
Pan woman, time at McDonald's.
When does complete sinus relief come together? When you get maximum strength Sinutan. With maximum decongestant to let you breathe again. Maximum antihistamine to dry up runny nose, watery eyes. Maximum non-aspirin pain reliever for throbbing headache. Complete sinus relief comes together in maximum strength Sinutan. You can't buy a stronger, more complete sinus remedy without a prescription.
Okay, we're going to be back in the ring with a six-man tag match in just a moment. Jerry.
I just wanted to come by real quick and kind of make an introduction. You know I wrestle all over the country.
Yep.
And last year I was wrestling up in Minneapolis, Minnesota, and I met a young guy up there named Rock and Roll Buck Zumoff. And this guy, I'm sure everybody's going to like the guy. I immediately, you know, he created a lot of excitement, a really likable young guy. And I told Buck at the time, I said, look, if you ever have the opportunity, you need to come down south because I know you'll like the area and I know the fans will like you. And, you know, I was talking to Eddie Marlin last week and he said, hey, a young man by the name of Buck Zumoff calling. I said, Eddie, you'll like the guy. So anyway, he's here and I just want everybody to welcome a good friend of mine and I know you're going to like him. Rock and Roll Buck Zumoff. He's going to be mine and Handsome's partner here.
Okay, he'll be in here for the first time. Here comes Handsome. He's in some kind of company, I'll tell you for a fact. As Handsome is coming out, Rock and Roll Buck Zumoff. He's got him a flare right there. Wild and Willie. So it'll be Lawler, Handsome Jimmy, and Rock and Roll Buck Zumoff. In our final six-man tag match. Jimmy likes the music too, Dave. Executioner Jerry Bryan and Joe Lightfoot coming in as the opposition for... we don't know that much about Buck, only by reputation, but certainly we know Lawler and Banya. We're ready for the introduction, Dave.
All right, match to the expiration of time. Total weight 670 pounds from Memphis, Tennessee, Jerry Bryan. From parts unknown, the executioner. And from Quebec, Joe Lightfoot. Going against him, total weight 705 pounds from New York City, Handsome Jimmy Valiant. From Minneapolis, Minnesota, Rock and Roll Buck Zumoff. And from Memphis, Tennessee, the King, Jerry Lawler. This match, the expiration of time. Jerry Calhoun, the referee. Six-man tag team rules in effect.
Okay, we're going to pare it down to start out with one apiece, and we'll see who it is going to be. It looks like Quebec in three. Joe Lightfoot is going to be starting out. Lawler is set and ready to go. So, Buck Zumoff sitting in the tire. And I think we are ready for the action. Bell time, here we go.
It's the King against Joe Lightfoot. Lightfoot out of Quebec. He came in this area a few weeks ago, and he said, I'm challenging everyone. Understand this is tag team territory. And he's got that right. He has run into some competition. Some of the toughest he's in here against right now. And the person of the King, Jerry Lawler. He's got a headlock, a face lock on him. Rock and Roll Buck Zumoff over in the corner with Handsome Jimmy Valiant. And between the two of them, they got the crowd going here. Joe Lightfoot. Tossed across the ring by the King.
Rock and roll, rock and roll, rock and roll, rock and roll.
him across the ring is in the arm drag. Joe Lightfoot goes after Lawler again. Ooh, this time he jabbed him in the throat. I think he got him with a point of the fingers. Couldn't see from this angle. See, at that time, he did. Open hand, and he jabbed Lawler in the throat with a point of the fingers. Lawler comes back with a right hand, figuring that makes him a little bit even. There's Joe Lightfoot. A good shot of him. Lawler held up by Jerry Bryant outside. Now the executioner holding him up. Bryant steps through the rope. Tag has been made, and it's going to be Jerry Bryant. Whoa! Tag made, and here it comes. Rock and roll. Buck Zumoff against Jerry Bryant. He flips it. Zumoff going for the drop kick, and he got it. Back Bryant into a corner. Zumoff taking charge immediately as he stepped into the ring. Bag made, and here comes the boy from New York City, Boogie Woogie Man himself. Bryant puts Bryant into the rope. Lightfoot jumps in. Baggett goes after him. Here's the executioner. Baggett's after him. Baggett has to take on all of them. Now Bryant and Lightfoot sit back to the corner. Baggett. Lawler. Double elbow. And the executioner off the ropes. Nice suplex by the King. 3 minutes, 20 seconds gone. Right hand action from Lawler on the forehead. Time beginning to wind down, an expiration of time here. We're getting close. We'll keep an eye on it. Meanwhile, the action continues. Rock and roll. Buck Zumoff with a body slam on the executioner.
Winding that arm. I thought it was going to come off in his hand there. Boy, he got the executioner.
Valiant takes the tag from Lawler. Both of them send the executioner into the ropes, and they're waiting there with that upper arm. Boy, these two guys have worked together as a tag team. But here's a cover. One, two, and three. First fall is history. It goes to Valiant, Lawler, and Buck Zumoff.
The win in that first fall is, Dave said, Lawler, Valiant, and Zumoff in the first fall. We're going to have to check our time, and we'll find out whether we have any of it left. Let's take time out. We'll be back in just a moment.
Smell this fresh-cut cedar.
Nothing can penetrate this stuffy nose.
This can.
Halls Lipo Lipstick?
Mm-hmm. With vapor action.
Even in the worst cold, Halls Vapor Action penetrates deep into clogged nasal passages to help your stuffy nose feel clearer, while Halls soothes your throat to help your cough.
Hey, I feel much better now.
Good. You split.
For penetrating relief, get Halls Vapor Action.
Discover the quick response and smooth performance of Exxon Extra, our highest octane unleaded premium gasoline ever. Its extra boost of octane quiets the knocks, silences the pings for extra smooth performance. Exxon Extra, quality you can count on.
Happy birthday! Happy birthday,
Don't take it out on your battery. Tune up for fast starts at Expert Tune. Your engine is computer analyzed and expertly tuned by certified mechanics you can talk to. A 30-minute guaranteed tune-up at Expert Tune costs less than a new battery. Expert Tune. For starters.
How do you spell relief?
R-O-L-A-I-D-S. If you got heartburn, you get 100% relief because it's gone.
For millions of Americans, Rolaid spells 100% relief.
Okay, I think our time split out after that first one in here. It was a good, spirited one.
Well,
Buck Zumoff, I loved watching his action.
What a team that is with Zumoff, Handsome Jimmy, and the King.
Listen, let me give you a reminder again that five championship matches tomorrow night. We also want to tell you children 10 and under admitted to general admission by $1. And that's all, my friend. So make it a point to be down there with us. You're going to see some great action, and we hope maybe you'll be right there with us. 8 o'clock. Dave, how about our...
All right, just winners. Intern and Playboy Frazier, the Dirty White Boys. Kevin Kelly, the Blonde Bomber. First look at him. He won. Eddie Gilbert and Iron Mike Sharp won their match. Lawler, Valiant, and Zumoff won the main event.
Okay, that's it. We got more next week. Until we see you at that time, Lance Russell for Dave Brown saying bye-bye, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of Championship Wrestling.
A Southern Tag Tournament. That's right. Last week in the Gardens, the belts were held up. Now, we're going to be showing you a piece of a match between the interns and the Dirty White Boys that caused the belts to be held up. Let's take a look at that right now.
There's a cover by Tony Anthony. The referee's still down. Hart comes running to ringside with his cane. The referee counting one, two, three. I don't know who he's counting on. He signals for the end of the match, and it's going to be 9 minutes and 19 seconds. But I don't know who he was counting on. Anthony grabs one belt. Intern number two grabs the other belt.
You guys wouldn't agree to a return match, so Eddie Marlin had nothing to do with scheduling
the
tournament.
Lance Russell would agree under a return match when we beat those Dirty White Boys right out straight, and we were the champions. Now they got a big tournament, Jack. They got all the people in the world, Stan and Steve, the fabulous ones, 11 big teams in it right here, baby, for our belts. Well, Jack, I'm going to tell you something, baby. Tuesday night, when the smoke clears and the dust settles, I guarantee the interns going to be the new, once again, Southern Heavyweight Tag Team Champions.
That's right, baby.
We'll start out with see it Tuesday. Tuesday night, the Louisville Gardens, big action of the Southern Tag Team Title Tournament. The first round pairings will go with the Nightmares against the Daydreamers, Terminators going against Yamamoto and Kyle, the Batten Brothers against Adrian Street and Danny Hager, Randy Savage, Lanny Poffo face Kevin Kelly and Joe Lightfoot, the Interns against the Dirty White Boys, and also Stan and Steve, the fabulous ones, facing Eddie Gilbert and Iron Mike Sharp. 11 matches in all. There will be a winner coming up Tuesday night, the Louisville Gardens. Tuesday night, Louisville Gardens going to be a Southern Tag Team Tournament. Listen to the first round pairings. The Nightmares against the Daydreamers, Terminators against Yamamoto and Steve Kyle, the Batten Brothers against Street and Danny Hager, Randy Savage and Lanny Poffo against Kevin Kelly and Joe Lightfoot, the Interns against the Dirty White Boys, and Eddie Gilbert and Iron Mike Sharp will be going against the Fabulous Ones. Right now, let's listen to Stan Lane.
You know, the Fabulous Ones have been all over the country for the past 9 months, but now we feel like it's time to come home. And I'm talking to you, Louisville, Kentucky, one of the biggest tag team tournaments ever to be held in Louisville Gardens. And Stan and Steve, the Fabulous Ones, are going to be there. Eddie Gilbert, you tried to mock us. You tried to steal what it took us years to perfect. We're coming for you and your partner, Iron Mike Sharp. We got you in the very first round, so guys, get ready for a mouthful of dust because you're going to be biting it.
The Fabs want those belts back, brother, and there's a lot of other teams to do, too. You're going to have to be right here. That's on Tuesday, Louisville Gardens, Southern Tag Team Tournament, 11 matches in all. You can't afford to miss this one. Okay,
Hey, final word to remind you, coming up next Tuesday. First, let me say this. Wednesday, February the 20th, Championship Wrestling at Owenton, Kentucky. And by golly, next Tuesday, right here, 11 matches to decide the Southern Tag Team title holders. The titles are vacant. One of the matches will be the team of Kevin Kelly and Joe Lightfoot going against the impressive team of Lanny Poffo and Randy Savage.
Well, we're not going to underestimate those opponents. No way. No, you're talking Southern Tag Team titles. And we get rid of them. We go on to either the interns or the Dirty White Boys. So it gets crazy later on.
That's right. Got to win several before it's all through, Lane.
Joe Lightfoot speaks with forked tongue. Him and anybody's a lousy tag team combination.
We'll find out. That's just one of the matches, and I'll tell you one is going to be something else. Dirty White Boys, opening round, you got the interns, your chance to get it back.
You know, some of the interns want to stand out here and say, hey, we beat the Dirty White Boys time after time. This shouldn't be a tournament. But if anybody watched that little videotape y'all had on here earlier, they can see the only reason the belts are held up, the only reason the belts aren't around our waist right now is because of Jimmy Hart. Well, interns, we got you in the first round. I want to tell you something, big boys. Bring on out to the ring in Louisville. We're going to get nasty. We're going to get dirty right off the start, brother. The Dirty White Boys ain't asking for no favors. The Southern Tag Team title's on the line. Tag Team Tournament, Louisville, Kentucky. Be ready for it, Jack. Be ready for the Dirty White Boys.
Okay, that's next Tuesday. You'll see that match. You'll see the fabulous ones who'll be against Gilbert and Sharp. Lots of other action next Tuesday for the tournament.
Tuesday night, the Louisville Gardens, big action of the Southern Tag Team Title Tournament. The first round pairings will go with the Nightmares against the Daydreamers. Terminators going against Yamamoto and Kyle. The Batten Brothers against Adrian Street and Danny Hager. Randy Savage, Lanny Poffo face Kevin Kelly and Joe Lightfoot. The Interns against the Dirty White Boys. And also Stan and Steve, the fabulous ones, facing Eddie Gilbert and Iron Mike Sharp. 11 matches in all. There will be a winner coming up Tuesday night, the Louisville Gardens.
Mike Sharp depositing the championship belt he has on the way to the ring in a non-title match here. Tag team match coming up. One fall, 10-minute time limit match. Total 491 pounds over on the left side of the ring. Introducing from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, Iron Mike Sharp. His partner from Lexington, Tennessee, Hot Stuff, Eddie Gilbert. They have Jimmy Hart in their corner. And going against him at a total weight of 454 pounds from Charleston, West Virginia, the Batten Twins, Mark and Brad. This match will be one fall, 10-minute time limit, and the referee is Jerry Calhoun. All right. Eddie Gilbert, Hot Stuff, starting against one of the Battens. I got to tell you, I find it very difficult
like
to tell
company,
Mark
neighbor?
And Brad apart.
Well, you got company, baby. Guess who's coming to dinner?
Jimmy Hart joining us at the desk for a Sterling brand of commentary, I'm sure. Eddie Gilbert, a little shocked at the goings-on. Jimmy Hart leaves his commentary position here, thank goodness. He goes back for a little word of conversation with Iron Mike Sharp and Eddie Gilbert. Meanwhile, the Batten Brothers waiting patiently. Gilbert backs him into the ropes. Referee wants a break. Clean one. He gets it. Gilbert then let him have it with a right hand. Batten moved out of the way. Gilbert tried to hold up.
That's okay. He's tough, baby. He's tough. Gilbert's tough, baby.
Made a big mistake early in the match. High five by the Batten Brothers.
High five by the Batten Brothers.
Hey,
oh, big deal, big deal.
Used their
twins,
head,
man.
Outsmarted Hot Stuff, Eddie Gilbert. Made him look bad. Look out. Mike Sharp with that big
beautiful,
forearm.
Mike, beautiful. Never turn your back on the family. You know what our motto is? Like I told you last week, baby. The cheap shot, baby, is the best shot.
Yeah. The admission from Jimmy Hart, that's 2 weeks in a row we've heard the phrase. We've known that for a long time, but he's finally admitted it. First family members using the cheap shot at every opportunity. Mike Sharp.
Beautiful, Mike. Beautiful, baby.
Ramming Batten's head into the turnbuckle. First on one side of the ring and then the other. I got Gilbert's foot. Ooh, and Batten's head bounces about 2 feet back after he ran into the foot. I'm Eddie Gilbert.
You know, the bands, they look cute, all right. Look, the little beards are trimmed nice and neat. They've got the little college hairstyle that all the college boys wear. Look, the little black knee pads matching, the little white boots, right? But the only thing wrong with it, they don't know how to wrestle, man. Look at Mike Sharp and look at Eddie Gilbert. Now, they know how to wrestle. They know what to do in the ring. They know when they get in trouble exactly what to do, baby. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful?
Gilbert flying through the air. Nails back.
Pull him up. Pull him up. Beautiful, Eddie. Pull him up, baby.
He did pick him up by the hair at the count of one.
Look at that. Beautiful.
Fist. Doubled fist. Both of them.
Like I said, baby, 85 is going to be the first family's year. You know, I thought 84 was going to do it, but I had a couple of slow leaks in there like the Dirty White Boys, man. It set me back about 6 months.
Backdrop by Eddie Gilbert. Hot stuff. Has taken control of the match. He makes a tag now on Iron Mike Sharp, his partner in the corner.
You know, why don't his brother come in and help him? He saw it right there. Why he didn't? Because, see, there's a weak link on every team, baby, except the first family team. I don't put any weak links in the first family. If they are weak, we get rid of them.
The weak link in this case you're talking about is abiding by the rules. The Batten's waiting for the tag, and the first family paying very little attention to the rules.
That's right. Slap him, Eddie. That's right, baby.
From
slap
outside,
him.
Outside, Eddie Gilbert popped him with an open hand.
Show him who the king is, baby. Show him who the boss in the ring is, baby.
Oh, that big forearm. That arm brace that Mike Sharp wears that so many wrestlers have complained about.
You know what? And they complain about it. Everybody knows what happened to Mike Sharp's arm. He was hurt playing cocky, man.
Everybody knows what Mike Sharp says happened to his arm.
And I can't even talk today. I feel like an elephant sitting on my tongue. He was hurt playing hockey out here. I was just warming your chair up for you, Russell.
Thank you for keeping it warm, Jim.
Sharp being backed away by the referee. And look at Eddie Gilbert from outside on the apron. Even Batten tied up in there. Look out, Eddie Gilbert with a suplex. There's a cover count as one, two, and Gilbert picks him up by the hair at the count of two. Again, Gilbert and Sharp, that team, refusing to go for the count of three. Whether they could have gotten it or not, we don't know, but fact is, he didn't even go for it. Batten thrown through the ropes, down onto the floor. Look out, Mike Sharp. Ooh. Throwing him into and over the desk. I'm lying on the floor over here. That's no excuse.
Watch him over here.
Yeah, watch him. Get him away from it.
Funny.
No, he's laying out there because his brother didn't help him. His brother's not going to help him.
Oh, yeah, Mike Sharp grabbing him again down here on the floor.
You know what? Everybody wants to dress alike. Look at you and Dave Brown even dressing like. These kids dressing like, but it still doesn't make you good announcers. It still doesn't make you good wrestlers, baby.
Thank you, Jimmy.
Eddie Gilbert. Trying to take advantage of the opportunity after Batten was thrown over our desk down here. Look out, drop kick by Eddie Gilbert. He caught him in the midsection. The Battens have been in trouble a good part of this match. Eddie Gilbert climbing the ropes now. Hot stuff. Going for the smash. And Batten was not there. That's the second time in the match that Eddie has missed. Here's Mike Sharp in after
the
tag.
Got him yet.
Oh, I haven't got him yet. I'm a very, very busy man, baby. I've been flying all over the world the last 3 or 4 weeks, the last couple of months. But now I'm back in town to take care of business, baby.
Two count by Sharp, and he picked him up. As again.
Workout. We could have beat these punks maybe 5 minutes ago, but we just want to have a little workout before our big match.
Oh, boy. Yeah,
the arrogance of
you hit the word right on the head. Oh.
He got Batten hung up on the top rope there. Gilbert holding up there. Hart
looking at
his hair. Batten really needs to get back over to the corner to tag his brother. They have kept him in there forever.
Really gets under your skin, man. I will tell you what.
We have just passed the 7-minute mark. Overall time limit, 15 minutes on this one.
Oh. Sharp with that pounding arm with that brace on it.
Gilbert comes in with a forearm. Eddie Gilbert with a cover. Count is 1-2, but again he picks him up with a 2 count.
We'll beat him when we're ready to beat this little punk.
Using hair and you in the corner and everything.
I tried to help him back in the ring, man. You
Jimmy,
saw that.
You quit that. Come on, get him up now. I think everybody's an idiot but you.
You said it, I didn't.
Gilbert with a power slam. Crowd trying to get something going to inspire the batters.
Well, Gilbert and Sharp, they just had it going. Look at here now.
Reversal. Sharp's head banged into the turnbuckle. And the batters win. Going after him. One's got Mike Sharp, the other Eddie Gilbert, and they run together in the center of the ring. Outside, Frazier with a chair, Gilbert with a cover, 1, 2, and 3, this one's over. Outside interference. Out, Frazier comes in here.
Used everything but wrestling tactics in there. You grab the chair, arch out
of
here.
You don't even understand what you're talking about, you narrow nose, not you.
Yeah, well, I want to tell you one thing. You guys didn't end up there beating them all that easy. As Jimmy
I'm
going to
tell you one thing, too. You listen, and you boys, you listen. They've been running around here telling everybody how bad they beat me. They ain't beat me. 2 midgets can't beat me. 10 midgets can't beat me. Ain't nobody going to beat me.
They got $500 of yours.
They ain't nobody.
That's right. Nobody's ever taken that.
You crazy.
He's tired of spreading lies on Playboy Frazier. These 2 midgets can't beat anybody. This is one of the greatest wrestlers in the world.
And they shut up calling me a big fan. I ain't no big fan.
You know what? I'm sick and tired of my men being abused by these people. Look at this. Come on, Playboy. Come on, Playboy.
There's a few other people that are sick and tired of stuff just like taking Batten and firing him all the way over the top of this desk in here. Absolutely ridiculous when they use that kind of tactics. Right. We had Hart jerking his hair out here. Frazier picks the chair up in there. The Battens didn't have it. There it is. Look at here. Frazier holding the chair. Now, don't tell me that he wasn't interfering from the outside. Unfortunately, the referee was tied up trying to get the other pair separated in there. And Batten's head run right smack dab into the chair, and that counted for the 1-2-3. We've got more action. We've got us a big 6-man match coming up with the King and Handsome Jimmy, and we'll be meeting Rock and Roll Buck Zumoff in just a few minutes.